Submissions on the defence review come to a close this week, and with retention rates way down, there are calls for major changes to how New Zealand's army operates. Here's Whena Owen.
Wednesday, Land Guard Bluff outside Whanganui, where this army base is under attack.
Effectively, we've got an insurgency group that's made its way into Whanganui. They've established themselves in the city itself.
Don't panic though, this is just an exercise with Linton-based combat specialists to train rifle platoon commanders, and they're into it.
Stuff like this is really good because we have enemy party. It's unfortunate that it's the boys that we know, but actually having to have force-on-force operations is actually quite good training. And being in an environment outside of Linton is quite nice.
Lance Corporal Jack Cavell came off 7 stints working in MIQ facilities.
We did feel like we were doing something that was actually meaning and worthwhile to the country. As we were saying before, there aren't actually a lot of deployments going on right now, so doing anything was good. It did drag on for a while.
In the last 2 years, the regular Defence Force has lost 29.8% of its uniformed trained personnel.
Talking to a lot of my friends who have gotten out recently, they do miss the camaraderie and the friendships that you can make. It really is second to none compared to anywhere else. You won't have friends anywhere else other than how you do here.
That's something retired Major Tony Williams would attest to. The former SAS officer has been in and out of the army since he was 15, with a variety of roles and deployments, finally leaving in 2019. That's plenty of time to think about how we can do defence better.
I like to make the point up front, you know, that anything I say is with absolute respect and aroha for all the past, all the present and all future service people. I mean, I have a total respect for them.
He believes for decades our military's tasks and scope has been too broad. With mounting geopolitical tensions, that needs to change quickly.
We need to focus, bring the focus from Northern Hemisphere, going and helping these allies who, in the end, just see it as a token effort anyway, and regardless of what we think, is that do something around our own Southwest Pacific zone to help them be secure, be well, and be prosperous.
The need to tilt more to the Pacific has already been signalled by the Defence Minister, building on a long relationship in the region around humanitarian and disaster relief and defence exchanges. Among these troops in Whanganui are soldiers from Tonga and Fiji training to lead their Pacific platoons. New Zealand would now struggle to rustle up battalion numbers. Tony Williams thinks we should instead be developing highly trained specialist units along the lines of the US SEALs.
Well, in the eyes of our allies, be highly effective on operations and not a paper division that we're basing on sort of World War II theory and philosophy. That doesn't work. It's not working and people are getting out in droves.
But British and Australian Defence Forces are also contending with staff attrition, a problem often attributed to the cost of living crisis driving people toward private sector salaries.
I've lived in 3 states this year. I've met so many new people.
Australia, though, has a head start in its recruiting, picking up personnel from its successful but expensive gap year program, a kind of national service.
I've been saying for a long time that we need a gap year in New Zealand. A lot of people leave high school, they don't know what they're going to do.
So it's not conscription?
No.
It's a voluntary...
It can be voluntary, can't it?
Back at the unfolding situation in Whanganui, there are concerns the insurgents may have reached the base.
So we have a problem because the enemy have been spotted in those bunkers on top of the hill, and most of the troops in the base there have been sent into Whanganui to patrol the town.
Time to let the dogs out.
This is one of our infantry support dogs. During our last attack, this is the only dog that hasn't managed to have a bite.
Right.
So he's super excited.
So is the insurgent, is he in a bite suit, is he?
Yes, he's in a bite suit, just for safety reasons. So, and they're well trained.
Here we go, over he goes.
While the government has handed out bonuses to personnel, it's now working on longer-term retention measures and awaiting the outcome of the defence review. This retired soldier has seen reviews come and go, but still has hopes for this one.
They won't be afraid to make some big changes.
Back on the hill, they're closing in on the enemy.
You can see he's still trying to run away. The soldiers are telling him to stop. They've released the dog. The dog will hold him in location, then the soldiers will take him down.
He drew the short straw then, this guy here. So he's one of your men?
He's one of our soldiers, yeah.
He's a good actor.
He is. They all get into it and play the enemy party.
It's been a successful exercise, which will now be reviewed in detail.
The reason why I joined was to deploy in the real world and do this sort of thing for real.
So these guys and women are really into it, aren't they?
Oh, absolutely.
This is better than standing in an MIQ hotel lobby.
Oh, they love it. Like, they love getting out there and doing their job, particularly, you know, when you've got dog handlers and that sort of side and you're trained to get out there and do this sort of stuff. This is what it's all about, yeah.
Whena Owen with that report. And yes, in case you were worried, it looks like Whanganui was successfully recaptured by the army. Ka pai te mahi.